MFA Updates.
Good morning. สวัสดีค่ะ and welcome to MFA Update, a weekly program that focuses on Thailand's international affairs and activities. I am Kimmy or Kim Panikmichakrairok, your host. And today I bring you to Poland. My guest, His Excellency Chetapan Maksampan. He's the Thai ambassador in Warsaw. So this episode, you will learn more about Thailand and Poland cooperation opportunities and potentials.
The Foreign Affairs That Matter. Special guests from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. This is the MFA Updates.
สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ Very glad to be able to talk to you today.
Okay.So how is the weather there? I heard that in October is the perfect time in Poland.
The weather is quite cold now because it's the end of summer. It's autumn in Poland. It's getting a bit chilling, but mm-hmm. it's very nice still, not very cold. So more people are coming here to travel as well.
Wow. So a lot of people might not be familiar with Poland. So can you tell us a little bit about this country?
Yes, I would love to, because when we talk about Poland, people might not know much about it because there are not a big number of Thai tourists coming here yet.
Mm-hmm.
But to tell you briefly, Poland is the fifth largest population in EU with a population of 38 million people. It's situated in Central Europe. So it's a strategic location between West Europe and then Eastern Europe.
Mm-hmm.
It's neighbor with Germany, Russia, and many other countries as well.And Poland is also the economic powerhouse of Europe as well. We can see that despite the COVID situation, the GDP is expected to grow of about 4.8%, and then it has the lowest unemployment rate in EU, so with very, very amazing number.
Uh-huh.
So we can see that Poland is growing fast, quite fast, in terms of economics. But when for the Thai people to think about Poland, I would say that,If I mention these names, you might not know that they are Polish, but actually they are. For example, Frederick Chopin, who is the pianist.
Yeah.
Pope John Paul II,
mm-hmm.
he is the first non-Italian Pope in 400 years. Marie Curie, the physicist and scientist who got the Nobel Prize Award for 2 times.
And yeah.
even Nicholas Copernicus, who is the astronomer and who discovered that, the Earth is not evolving around the sun, but actually, not the sun evolving around the Earth, but the sun is the center of the universe. And also Poland is, you will be amazed to know that Poland is a major inventor in many, many technology. For example, portable mine detector, walkie-talkie, bulletproof. Mm-hmm. They are all invented by Polish engineer in the past.
Interesting. So why Poland can be an important new frontier for Thailand? Please explain about it.
It's a very good question.Because I also asked myself that, and then I discovered that there are 3 areas of frontier that can be a good cooperation between Thailand and Poland. The first one is the bilateral relation.
Mm-hmm.
Poland is one of the major trade partners of Thailand in Central and Eastern Europe, with the trade volume of about $1 billion US dollars. That's an increasing number as well.
Mm-hmm.
And also, we look at Poland as a gateway of between Thailand and Poland, because we see that Poland can be the gateway for Thai investors and traders in not only in Central and Eastern Europe, but also in Western Europe, with a population of altogether 500 million people. And also we would like Poland to see Thailand as a gateway for trade and investment in ASEAN or in Southeast Asia region with a population of 650 people as well. This is the second dimension that we see the potential between Thailand and Poland. Last but not least is mm-hmm. the cooperation in multilateral fora, because mm-hmm. Poland has adopted pragmatic approach towards Thailand and has been a great supporter and a friend of Thailand in many international fora, for example, in EU and also at the United Nations. You can see that, as I mentioned, Poland has a strategic location and also in terms of an economic powerhouse in the region. And so many investors and traders are interested in coming to invest in Poland, including Thai investors as well. There are many big well-known companies from Thailand investing here, for example, Lucky Union, Thai Union, the CPF, and also Indorama. They altogether, the investment amounted to about $500 million, and then they employed about 4,000 employees here in Poland. So Thailand has gaining a big presence here in terms of investment and trade. And then other than that, other investment, there are also many Thai-related businesses here in Poland. There are about almost 300 Thai-related businesses here. We have an increasing number of Thai restaurants, Thai spas, and you will be amazed to hear that there are about 200 Muay Thai training camp here in Poland, popular sport here in Poland. And also, on the contrary, we can see that Poland would like to go to Thailand to invest and to become trade partner as well, because I have been discussing with many Polish traders and entrepreneurs, the Chamber of Commerce, and then they are also interested in going to have a trade partner in Thailand in terms of agricultural products, food products, including innovation as well. And also there are some potential that we can see, not only the traditional trade and investment, but in terms of other innovation and technology. We identify that Poland can be in synchronized with Thailand in terms of food technology, agriculture technology, and also medical technology, and also IT.
So how can the embassy promote cooperation between Thailand and Poland?
I think you asked a very important question about how, because this is what we have been thinking much about it, because we know that the embassy cannot work alone on this one. So I think our strategy would be about, we have three strategies. The first one is we like to be bridge builder. I mean, the embassy can be a bridge builder between the government of both sides or the agencies involved, for example, the Ministry of Economics or Ministry of Trade. And also we would like to be a bridge builder between the Thai private sectors, as I mentioned earlier, not only Thai investors or Thai traders, but also with the Thai Chamber of Commerce, with the Polish Chamber of Commerce. That's why in the past we have been discussing many meetings with the Chamber of Commerce also, and also at the level of the academic and university level, that we would like to also to link them together between Thai University and Polish University in terms of R&D, research and development, in terms of technology. So this is one strategy. The second one is to synergize our work together with the Thai community, and also Thai-related businesses, as I mentioned. And last but not least, it is friends of Thailand. I mean, friends of Thailand, because we have so many Polish people who are great friends of Thailand, who have been in politics or who have been in the private sector. So we would like to work together with them to make it more powerful for our cooperation. And last but not least, our strategy would be to emphasize on digital and public diplomacy, because at this time, you know, because of the COVID situation, and then we see the potential that we can do more in terms of a digital platform to promote the understanding and cooperation between Thailand and Poland. We would like to change the mindset as well, not because the Polish people, when they talk about Thailand, they know Thailand about our culture, tourism, but we would like to let them know more that Thailand can be beyond that, because we have many potential that we can work together with them, especially in terms of trade, technology and innovation.
Are there any opportunities to further enhance in this aspect?
Yes, of course, because especially next year, Thailand and Poland will celebrate the 50th anniversary of diplomatic relations. So we would like to see this as an important momentum to further enhance the tie between the two countries that you asked. Especially in terms of economy. So what we plan to do is we would like to work together with our friends of Thailand, our partners, to promote, for example, like a trade forum in terms of a meeting or digital meeting or webinar, and also a B2B, like a business matching as well between those Thai private sectors who would like to do to find a trade partners here in Poland and vice versa. And also we have a mechanism with, like a political consultation as well.
Mm-hmm.
And we also have the joint trade commission between Thailand and Poland. And then this one is also we would like to use this mechanism to discuss the possibility and potential of cooperation in the future.
How about the cultural aspect, namely the people-to-people connection between Thailand and Poland? Can you elaborate about this?
I think that people-to-people connection is fundamental to everything, right? Because we want to, because it has to start with the people. If they have a good understanding and they have the right knowledge about between Thailand, Thai people, Thai culture, and vice versa, and this is a good thing that I also mentioned that mm-hmm. When you talk about Thailand to the Polish people will think that Thailand is one of the popular tourist destination for them. They would like to go. Their travel destination is Phuket Island.
Mm-hmm.
They look forward to going back to visit Thailand in the future when everything is open. So this is enough potential. Before the COVID time, there was about 25% increase of Polish tourism, tourists going to Thailand.
Mm-hmm.
And apart from that, Thailand is famous in terms of food, Thai spa and massage, also Muay Thai. Right? And last but not least, Sepak Takraw.
Yeah.
It's getting quite popular too here in Poland. And you can see that not only we have more than 200 Muay Thai training camps here, but there are major events happen in Poland. For example, next year, there's going to be the European Championship Games here
mm-hmm.
in Muay Thai, right? And then in 2 years, for the first time ever, Muay Thai has enlisted in the European Games. So it will be a competition of Muay Thai in Europe, and then it will be happening here in Krakow, Poland. This is a big step for us because we hope that Muay Thai will be enlisted in the future to be in the Olympic Games. So this is one of the major cultural cooperation that we have together with the Polish people. Apart from that, it's about, let's say, Thai film is also quite popular. We have been working with our partner to promote Thai film for a while now, like a film festival here in Poland.
So please leave your message, such as for more detail about the Thai Embassy. Listener can visit the Facebook page of the Thai Embassy in Warsaw, right?
Yes, yes. Of course, we have many channels that you can follow us if you like. We have our Facebook. You can type in like Royal Thai Embassy Warsaw. So you find us on our website as well, and also Facebook and also Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And so I hope that we also publish all the news in Thai and also in English. So for those who are interested about our work and our cooperation and relations between Thailand and Poland, so you are welcome to join us. Thank you.
Okay. So thank you for joining me in this program. So by the way, hope to see you again in Poland, maybe at the European Game in 2023, as you just mentioned. So thank you very much. See you again until next time. สวัสดีค่ะ.
Thank you. Thank you. สวัสดีครับ.
Alright, and that was His Excellency Mr. Chetapan Maksampan, the Thai ambassador in Warsaw, discussing Thailand and Poland cooperation opportunities and potentials. Don't forget to follow the YouTube channel MFA Thailand and Facebook page FM88 Radio Thailand English, and also Radio Thailand World Service for more updates. And with that, we conclude Radio Thailand's MFA update. I'm Kimmy or Kim Paniknisakrayrek, so see you again until next time. Stay safe and stay healthy. สวัสดีค่ะ.
The Foreign Affairs That Matter. Special guests from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. This is the MFA Update.